Hey, Tyrion. But we'll find out what's happened in Americola in just a little bit. I'm in way- oh, there it is. And the fun thing of, like, I'm in way too many Discords because I can't find the ones that I usually post my links to. And then I forgot there's a batch that I just put in a folder. I really only go there to do that, and then I close the folder. Oh, geez. Yeah, when I upgraded my drives to M2 drives, I went ahead and had to get a new copy. It was great. I couldn't find my copies of Windows 10. Or at least, where the, something wasn't working right on it. Which I ended up having to get a copy of Windows 11. But the fun thing is my MOBO is missing a particular chip that it's looking for in the Windows 11 setup. So it was saying, like, everything else was passing with flying colors, except I was missing one sort of, like, authentication chip on my MOBO. And it was saying that I was like, no, your computer can't run Windows 11. And it's weird because it's, and then people managed to make a thing where, yeah, the TPM chip. So people have made versions of the Windows 11 installer that bypass that requirement. So I was able to, I bought a legitimate USB drive, which I then had to get a non-legitimate USB drive to, or at least install it to a USB drive in order to get Windows 11 working. Which is part of the reason why I kind of want to do a new build, because I think my computer, like, it's certainly strong enough to run a lot of stuff, but I just kind of, it acts a little funky with some very specific things, which kind of concern me. But other than that, it's fine, but I kind of feel like there's something up with it that I can't quite describe what's up with it, but something just feels off. Which is why I'm probably going to try and replace it sometime soon, hopefully. There's some funny things I'm trying to see if they pan out right, which hopefully that comes sooner rather than later. I'll be right back, and then I'll go ahead and start. All right. I'm back. Hey, Peter. And yes, we are going to be getting a lot of Michael Jones in a second. Let me just go ahead and make sure I am well situated. All right, that should be good. Let's go ahead and get this thing going. So, hello, and welcome to a Sunday edition of Load of Puzzles Journal.
I'm gonna hit this funny button right here. Hit it again.
Trying to get something. There we go. There we go. Ignore the sound effects. All right. So, hello. Why'd you get all tangled? How'd you get tangled in like the 2 seconds I was away? Okay. There we go. Anyway, yes. Hello. Welcome to a Sunday edition of Old Puzzle Journal. There is one minor housekeeping thing I want to mention is I ran a Discord poll. That was basically because I had the idea for a holiday themed journal that will be debuting next week. And I was wondering if I was potentially, since it is going to be December, if I'd run that journal through all three streaming days. That ended up not being popular, so Sunday's going to continue as is. So the announcement is things are going as normal. There's no real need for announcement, but I figured I'd mention that. Anyway, yes, that is too much holiday, even though it's weird. Let's go. It's Sunday, which means we're back. We're away from the trains. As I totally didn't forget to do something real quick, then I fixed it. And we're back in the library. And yes, last time we got ourselves to the halfway mark. And I felt like for this journal, since it is based in a library and also the fact that it's, well, book related, that we'll be taking a look at a game that I have mixed feelings about. But it's definitely a game that involves a book, and it's also, spiritually, why it's actually kind of the one of the things that inspired me to make Bibli a book, and in particular, why what her book is. So today we are playing Zoe's Revenge, Star Tropics 2. This is a game that's interesting for many reasons. One, it's a game that only, despite this being, well, it probably only came out in America because this game is incredibly American, despite being Japanese made. It is also a 1994 NES game, which means it's a game that came out in the last year that the NES was getting new games. And also, it is a sequel to a game one of Nintendo's probably more obscure franchises, quote unquote. I don't know how many games you need to have in a franchise to count as a franchise, but this one, Star Tropics and Star Tropics 2 are very much culture or cater to the American market. The first one came out in Europe, this one did not. And yeah, this one makes some changes that I have mixed feelings on. The grid system of the first one, I think, was a neat idea. It was a little clunky, but also for a first attempt, I felt like it was pretty good. They change it to a not grid-based system, which has its own set of problems. There's some merits to it, but I feel I still prefer the grid system. I'll see you soon. This also kind of takes a. There were some puzzles in Star Tropics 2. This one has some quote unquote puzzles, but I don't think they're very good. And they're the kind of puzzle which is basically bang your head on a wall until you find out a solution. Kind of puzzles, like a lot of obscure mazes and, oh, hey, you go through this area, if you step on the wrong thing, you get into a random encounter, so to speak. And that, I'm not a huge fan of that kind of style. But yes, also, the first game had a very 90s cartoon vibe to it. It was very much a Saturday morning cartoon kind of feeling. This one amps that up to 11, for better or for worse. But yes, this game is interesting in many different aspects. Now, let me make sure I have my things here. And also, let's go ahead and start. Also, this does have a little bit of an intro, so I'll go ahead and let that play. And here's our cast. This is Mike Jones, junior in high school and the hero of the story. A short time ago, Mike went on an incredible journey and began his vacation to the South Seas. See Star Tropics 1. It became a big adventure. Mike managed to save his uncle and 7 space children from evil aliens. Spoiler for the first game. A few months passed, Mike is now in school and everything seems to be back to normal. Death, Dr. Jones, Mike's uncle and the famous archaeologist. Dr. J found the escape pod of 7 space children while he was exploring some lost ruins in the South Seas. See also Star Tropics 1. He's now a stateside lab trying to decode strange cipher which is found on the escape pod. Once he discovers a cipher, our hero, Mike, could only find himself in the midst of another adventure. So I'm trying to fix my camera, because someone seems to be acting up a little bit. Mika, with the oldest of the space children, Mika is the daughter of Hirokon, leader of Argonia. Mika and the others were sent away by Hirokon to escape Zoda. She has leadership qualities of her father, as well as some newly discovered powers of mystical nature. As Mike is sent on his new journey, it's Mika who will send him important information from home. Okay, I think actually it's because I'm... There we go. Alright, here we go. So, I'm just going to delete that because I think I just did that as a test. Fun thing about playing this series on the mystery is you need a special version of the actual card. You need a special ROM for this. I don't know why. There's something about the header with this one that throws it off, but yeah. Okay, so let's go to this. Hey, Koyo. Okay, so also I'm going to be just as a, not disclaimer, but like as a point of note, because there are multiple, when this got released to Virtual Console, there were some changes made to the text for legal reasons. I am playing the original version, the one that was like the NES version. I'm not playing the Virtual Console version. Here, chapter 1. Hi, I'm Mick. How have you been? That's good. I'm back in Seattle. Do you remember my uncle? Let's say no. You will see in a moment. Well, you'll see at the end of this, the next chapter, why. It's mundane. Maybe you should read the manual to understand. Okay. no, it's not the song. It is the collectibles in this. Let's see. Also, I'm going to turn this down because it's a little out of my monitor. My uncle is Dr. Joe. Oh, also, I should say, this game doesn't have any fun, feely shenanigans. You don't have a special letter. You just get the game. Chop off. Call him Dr. J. Now he's in Seattle. Decoding the rest of that cipher from the tropics. He spends all of his time reading like crazy, trying to break the code. Here's Mika. Back in here. So the fun thing, this is just me being a dumb kid when I first played this. I didn't understand that the asterisks meant that it was your internal, like, it was like an action of, like, you're doing the thing. It's like saying you shout. I always thought that they were actually physically saying that. Like, it was some weird, like, catchphrase thing. But no. Let's see, expecting you to do, was it a cat I saw, was it a rat I saw? Yeah, it's... Yeah. Is the castle... Let's see. He's very busy. There's a little less question marks. Cypher's very tough. Yeah, yeah, it's our Uncle Steve Jones. I think that's supposed to be a sweater. I never actually looked at it that hard. That does kind of look weird. Also, I like this blah blah thing. Was it a cat or so? Was a rat? Also, I didn't quite fully get. I'm just gonna say no. So in case you don't quite understand this, we'll tell you. What's the fun thing about this? Was it a cat I saw? Was it a rat I saw? You take all the, you squish the phrase together, or. Yeah, so the thing is, reverse it, because it's a palindrome. Yes, get the Oxford Wonderworld. Okay, let me try some real quick. Okay. Also, the cipher is Papa Uma Papa Mau Mau. And yes, now that we did that, we're now flung into space. Yes. Chapter 1 is just the intro. Now we're in Chapter 2. It's like being in a sci-fi movie. Okay. So, I'm gonna do some... Yeah. So, I hear some people say they didn't like the music in this one. I disagree. I think the music is probably the best thing about this game. Also, excuse me while I go look something up so that I don't... I don't like that this is the first thing they drop you off into, because what this segment is a... Let's see the world map. Does this give me the... Okay, so we're gonna zoom in on this. So the thing with this... Actually, I might as well just fall into one. Ariel Spider right here. Ground has many holes ahead there, hidden by snow, so watch your step. So yeah, once you hit this point, if you step on the wrong tile, you will get It will basically, you know, we'll just do this one. It takes you to a thing. So, unlike the first game, you now can have a directional movement and you're not moved to tile. It's very interesting. Also, you can spin into place. This game does still use the same item system as the first one, although... this game also has a thing where the first game did not... Okay. The first game had a tendency not to give out stars and potions that often. Whereas we'll find, this game kind of gives them out like candy. Okay, so let's go. There we go. Okay. Son, poor Shorty. Someday a reliever shall come from the south. Our village shall await him. I am a caveman. A caveman I am. This game is very silly. See, it came from the south. You'll find out very shortly. Well, kind of shortly. From these two. Let's see, I'm taking my tools from Stone's Bones. And yes, here's our first weapon. So you don't get a yo-yo in this game, you get various sort of weapons. Okay, that's... Also... Let's go for dinner. It's good today. Also, there's one thing we need to do here, and it's take a look at this. If you're wondering, hey, this looks like it might be important. That's because it is. We're going to take a screenshot of this. South must be one from a proxy, so the southpaw reliever would come with it. He'd get it because he's good at baseball. Also, he's left-handed, I guess. A man munching monster, Yum-Yum, gulped down our children. Our best caveman tried in vain to stop Yum-Yum. No more victims. I ask you to drive Yum-Yum for our land. Mike, the southpaw reliever, can save us. Also, I don't... This game isn't too terribly long. We might finish this in one go. I have a feeling that we're going to get pretty close. Oh, so yes. Now saving our data. And also, the axe is just... It's just a front projectile. It's actually kind of funny. A lot, like, there's no grid for you, but enemies do move on the grid. Also, one thing about this game that is very odd, I'll say that as well. Or it's one of the more trickier things about this game. Because there's no grid movement, and you do have some slight air correction, jumping in this game is actually kind of dangerous. Because it does not auto-correct you. So it is very easy to just kind of jump into water when you don't need to. Or me to. You can't walk off the ledge, but you can... Yeah. There are... also, yes, I can't remember if it was the case in the first game, but yes, enemies do respawn. Yeah, also one nice thing about your main weapon is the fact that, unlike the first game, well, it's gonna be a spoiler for a little bit later on, actually not that much later on, your main weapon does not have the fun thing that the first game did, whereas if you lose health it loses power. That's relegated to something else, but we'll find that in the future. Okay, here we go. You still have the same jump distance as you did in the first game, so it's one tile, essentially, you can jump over. Oh. Yeah, but it... Yes. The thing is, though, this... Enemies kind of fall into a template in this game. Oops. Okay. Is that going to be the same? Okay. Okay, there we go. What? Well, maybe he shouldn't have tried to slap me for a lot of damage. Hey, Darko. I... Hold on to that thought, because it gets... This is... Okay. Here we go. Let me just prepare something real quick. Okay. Here we go. Oh, that's way too tiny. Give me like 1 second. I don't know what UDF is. Okay, let's take this. Oh, okay. Okay, so let's take this. There we go. Now you should be able to see it. Okay, so... Oh, in that case, I think I'm good. So yeah, I believe that if you fail this puzzle, that you have to go back and do the entire level again. Also, I like that they extend... the area, so you can forget what you did last. Okay, should be square and then triangle. There we go. Okay, here we go. Also, we're about to hit the boss, and there's a fun thing about the boss that I need to make sure that I don't do. Or I might do it to show it off. Also, it's been really stingy with drops. So I believe the boss is right here. So let me just show you something real quick. Yep, here it is. So he starts off munching on something. If you take the... If you kill the thing, the boss goes into hard mode. Which we're not gonna do. So yeah, this boss is infinitely easier. Also, yes, the heart thing triggers every time you jump. But sometimes you never expect it, sometimes it just kind of happens. There we go. Points? I still don't 100% know what the points are. Yeah, but here are the kids that were being fattened up so that he could eat them. Oh yes, also the guy was named Picasso. Which is not the only thing. Also, hey, we found a block. I believe it's the same system. It's something like, I forgot. It's like enemies that you don't kill get you points. Oh, that's a good point. Okay, here we go. So, now that we got that. Let's see, can you hear me? Not sure, told me what happened. Travel back in time, Hirokon must know what happened. With the Mystic Tetraz! So, I believe... I can't remember if the name Tetrad was removed, but they refer to Tetris later on in the game. Okay, let me try something. There we go. They refer to Tetris later on, and in later revisions of this game, they call it Puzzle, because they lost the Tetris license. This is 94, so Nintendo was very much still in its, hey, we have Tetris. Yes. So our doohickey that we, or their MacGuffin for this game, are the Tetrads. Oh yeah, it was definitely a thing that makes sense. Alright, so we're using Oxford Wonderworld again. Get Papa Oomow, Papa Mau Mau. Yeah, I don't think they did change the Oxford thing. I believe it's just Tetris. And now we're in Egypt. So a fun thing is that there is a secret at this point, which is relatively pointless because it doesn't save you that much, but... where is it? I believe it's here. Oh, right here. If you want to get a better weapon real quick, or like one level before you normally get it, you can go over here. It's Jack, Jack of all trades. I'll trade you for my bronze dagger. So yeah, you get the weapon upgrade you would normally get after this level that we're about to do now. So it doesn't save you a whole lot of time, but it does save you some time. Yeah, okay, so Tetra is training the block. Okay. Let's see, welcome to the land of Egypt. This is our queen's barge, you know. Egypt is Nile's gift. Here. Let's see, the queen's cat is hungry, so don't get too close. Pray for our queen, she has incredible beauty. Long live our beautiful queen. I keep the queen cool. What am I say? I'm one of her biggest fans. Ahaha, I'm so fun and helpful. Now you want to know the queen's beautiful? She's a knockout. Let's see. Please enter, the queen expects you. Oh hey, it's... Don't ask me anything, I'm just a snake. I am Cleopatra, Queen of the Nile. What brings you to my barge? You tell the whole story. Blah, blah. Seeking Tetrads. Blah, blah. Traveling. Blah, blah, blah. We might be able to help you. I know this Tetrad and I could take it to you for a price. Do you like pizza? I love pizza. It's my favorite. I ordered a large pepperoni. It's taken way too long. It's been 3 days already. Why must they keep their queen so waiting? It makes me so angry. Bring me pizza and I will take you to the Tetrad. and hold the intro, okay? Okay, so now we gotta go here. No, unfortunately we cannot. So we gotta go get our pizza. Tender loving thing, or tender loving care thing I should bring up, but. Okay. Dagger is the same. So yeah, doing this level, it kind of showcases one thing about this game, is that it has, like, enemy types that are kind of consistent throughout the thing, or throughout the levels, but they change the way they look. Also, panels that you jump on are work a little bit differently. If you can walk over on them, and if it's something you can jump on, you can do that. One thing about getting hit in the air, at least I believe it's the case, if you get hit in the air, I do not believe that you lose momentum. That's nice, at least. These things. You probably can't really see it on here. Oh, there we go. But yeah, they're very subtle. Things there. Okay. Just wanted to make sure. Possibly. I remember when I played it, I actually played this on a CRT, that it looked, it was, you could still see it, but yeah, it probably was a little bit harder to see. I actually want to say, I think I played this one first over the second one. Okay. Yeah, there we go. Oh yeah. Also, I want to make sure that the thing gets there. See that? See. Ah, cheesy cry from Rome. Yeah, let's rent the camel. And ride. The pizza's still warm. Alright, there we go. Now that I've got the pizza. Your turn if you have the pizza. That is true. And hey, it's from Caesar's Hut. Let's see. So we're gonna get Tetrad, okay? Itself, you'll find a great pyramid. The Tetrad is rumored to be within its walls. Rarely face danger of the pyramid, you'll reach Tetrad. Good luck on your journey. This is where you'd get the knife if you did not have it. Okay, so... even though I know that this is not where we need to go next... let's go to the pyramid. There is a thing here, and we don't have any way of going it. Okay, I guess we can't go here yet. So you need something special across the pyramid's magic field. Let's see. I came from the north? Some strange magic's going up there. Well, I guess let's go the go north. That magician in the field to the reeds to the north. I was out there, it's driving me bananas. Also, here's one of my least favorite parts of the game. Who likes invisibility mazes? And now it's time for me to look over here for this funny game facts window. To help this. It's not Oski, it's one of those fun maps that's done by, whoops, by that guy that does all the maps. else? Also, yes, there are some hit, some, forced battle sequences. Necessarily a bad one. It's the ice field that I feel is a little annoying, especially it's the very first thing you do. Not sure if I knew that. There are no random battles in the reed, thank you, or thankfully. Also, one thing about this game that's nice is that there are no ways to permanently lose a heart container. If you do not pick up the heart container in the level itself, you just will, you'll get it later. Like when you do the end of level life increase. You will get it then. And yeah, it's trigger spaces, but... kind of feels like a random battle. Even though it's sad. Oh, whoops, I didn't go far enough. And here we go.
Monkey! Welcome back, I've been expecting you. I'll be your monkey's uncle. The special ability I must give to you, it is the power of the mind. And yeah, so we'll now always have a secondary weapon, the psychic shockwave. We'll not find this out until later, but this is the weapon that has the weird mechanic from the first game where, depending upon how much health you have, it's the strength of the thing. It is also usually half as weak as your weapon. But now, we have this. Do that. As you can probably imagine, there are enemies where you have to use that weapon. So generally at first, it's not that useful. Later versions of it will become more useful. That is why you don't want to change your angle. These are the enemies that are here. I believe that technically the mine thing has a higher rate of fire, but other than that, it's still not really needed. Also the mummies that just kind of look like the Michelin Man. Also these platforms, any platform that's kind of like mobile or like fades away, those you can walk off, so you do want to be careful about those. Also, you want to not be. I'll be a little careful on those. Leave these guys, you don't want to. I think there's something if you don't want to look at them if you're, if they do that attack. Because I think they freeze you. But that might be a different enemy. Okay. They're blood skeletons. Okay. Thank you.
Oh, that was a good sprite limit right there. Okay, let's try our luck. Okay, good, we got the life back. Alright. Okay, that's a different enemy I'm thinking. So, also, as you can probably imagine, if the conveyor, like, pushes you to the, like, direction that the spikes are facing, you will just go straight headfirst into the spikes. Potions heal 5 hearts, like they do in the first game. Ah. Ah, fluke. Not so to use that. There we go. Now this puzzle kind of took me a while to figure out as a kid. Oh, I should have just done that. Oh well. But now that we got a flute, I wonder what might be an appropriate room to use a flute in. Ah, here, there's a snake on the wall, or on the floor. Then you do that, and snakes appear. So there are still some puzzles in this game, it's just not as many as the first one. Okay, is this the boss? No. Oh, okay, you can't walk off those. Okay, that's a thing. That's good. Okay, here's the boss. Yeah, thankfully you can't jump off. Oh, yeah, also you don't want to stand in front of it. Thank you.
Chapter 3. And we get the L shape. Or J. So if you missed that earlier heart container, we'd have gotten two hearts there. You hear, where am I? Here it is, 2021B Baker Street, London. I wonder who we're gonna run into here. Oh look, it's Sherlock Holmes. That a robbery would occur in the mid-evening midnight. That's why David Soda X intends to steal his curious stone. Wasn't there something like he has like to have certain aspects? Doggy. Talk to this guy. Well, let's be going out to the museum, hmm? Oh no, it's cop. Well, we're in jail now. This place is escape proof, huh? Also, I guess it's a museum. That's it. Let's see. Show you the stone. Oh, hey, it's the S piece? Oh, no, it's Zoda. Get chase and I'll cut him off. So into the sewers we go. Oh, and bar. Here we go. This level sucks. Because time for platforming. You can, and absolutely will, walk right the hell off those things. Actually, in general case, if you hear this music, that means the level's gonna suck. From what I remember this game. That was dumb. I could have done that better. Oh! Case in point. Also, it's just refresh our lives. Oh hey, it's a wizard. I'm sure this wizard will not teach just a random wizard. Okay. There's part of me that wants to maybe think about, especially if I do stuff like that. What do I have to play with this? Wait, what? Huh. Okay, that's weird. I'm curious. Oh. I don't think I should have done that. Okay, I got to see it. Thankfully, we're just right here. Hey, River. It's okay, we're back here. Thankfully, this game auto-saves fairly generously. I turned on the jump multiple times cheat and jumped out of the game, is what happened. I deserve that one. Okay. I just think it's like how in the first game that chapter 3 is like actually one of the harder chapters in the game. I think this one actually, if I remember correctly, is like weirdly harder than most of the other ones. Uh,
It's the one with chapter 3 is the one that is like weirdly long. I believe it's the one with the graveyard. It's the one that you start off shipwrecked and then you have to go do that really hard boss. It also has the biggest dick move in the game, arguably. The one where you basically take a 50-50 shot on whether or not you're gonna die instantly or not. Also, there's some good rats here. Ow! Yeah, I got some real small sock energy. There we go. Yeah, I've heard incredibly good things about that game. Yeah, it's rather short, which I... You know what? I feel like it's appropriate. I'm very surprised I didn't die there. Okay. I'm just gonna do that because this boss kinda sucks for reasons you probably can see why. Oh, by the way. They don't automatically open the door for you, because why wouldn't they? It's not nearly as bad as the one in the first game, but it's still, every time I take a jump, my heart stops. I have died a non-zero number of times trying to get the thing finished. Also, hey, I wonder where it's going. It does. And actually, I think this is where I got when my old stream layout. I believe this is also where I also. Oh, is that what's causing the issue with the webcam? There we go. Oh, right, there is something over here. Is this going to be worth it? Probably not. Dragon. I think that just bypasses half the stage. Okay, that actually might have been worth it. I don't know why they, Oh, that's what I was going to do. It's good because we're going to need potions, because I believe this is one of the harder bosses in the game. Ugh. I hate this level. Ow! This just hurt. Okay, this gotta be more than that. Okay, now we're back here. Okay.
Okay, we know what's up to the right. There's no reason to go there. Nope. I kind of miss the yo-yo too. That part. I see. Okay. Okay, so I believe going to the left will, go to the boss. If you could find the problem with why this boss fight's kind of annoying. Yep. Thumb is anytime they give you an item, it is going to be stronger than your default weapon. Remember, is the next? I think I know what the next stage is.
Oh hey, and there's the piece. You're a very clever suit. Now this, you tell a story. Yes, because there's Zoda X, there must be Zoda Y and Z. Thanks, Sherlock. Alright, here we go. Papa Mau Mau. I think I know which... Is this the... Yep, okay, we're here. Also, I'm gonna force an SRAM save. There we go. Alright, partner, there's gold in them dar hills. Let's see. Sorry, what? Okay. I believe this is one of those lovely cases where you gotta talk to literally everyone in town in order for the plot to progress. The ginger ale is on me. We might be about to do the cactus dance. Struck it rich, struck it rich. Rich! Yeah, your kid would brawl. See, howdy, partner. Howdy, partner. Welcome to the Silver Dollar Saloon. We have a shot of sarsaparilla. See, I have a shot of my red-eye ginger. Dynamite. And yes, here we go. Want me to play my greatest hit? Yes. Here goes. Now I've done it. I hit Pater. Rich is what I am in the town. All will learn. There's gold in them dark hills, and it brought me many thrills. Now it's gold that you can earn, but there's a step you must learn. It's the cactus dance. Do the cactus dance. Everybody in the desert, do the cactus dance. Step lane, don't you stick? Seek a special cactus and make it quick. Face the cactus if you might, then take the 2 steps left and 3 steps right. Left again, and that's all. Keep on walking until you hit the wall. Cactus dance, did cactus dance? Shake up the shack with the cactus dance. Lost my is yours, you want that too? Just blast the wall and you'll get through. Spelt wrong, because it couldn't fit into the deck. Did you know that this game was made in the 1990s? Okay. So yes, that is the thing for this chapter. Okay, now that we've done that, I think this man would have... Okay, no, not yet. Let's see. Also, character pressure on the self, that's why you don't get pricked by needles. Looks like you've been through a lot. What brings you to this part? You tell the story, blah blah blah. I still recall a strange rock like your teetot rod. It's the mine that has been buried by a landslide. If you blast the right place, you'll open the way and get your teetot rod. I wish I could remember exactly where that was, but it's been a while. Good luck. Okay. If you blast the right place, okay. I forgot to see Scrab play these games. Hey, Pokemon, come
Last two walls, huh? Just getting started. Let's just hand this 10 or this 15-year-old dynamite. Okay, so. Basic gimmick or puzzle of this area. Hey, there's a field. Which the cactus dance, do it properly. If you walk up to one of these walls, you'll blow a hole in it, or you'll attempt to blow a hole in it, and some of these have stuff, some of these do not. I am going to cheat. And find where all the holes is, because there's a couple of these I want, and some of these I don't. So this one went first. You got a big heart. So yeah, they did hide a heart container in here. Okay, I'm trying to remember. And yeah, if you go look at these cacti, you'll notice that this one has its arm bent down. That's the one you're supposed to do at the cactus stands nearby. Except I never got it to work right. And every time you do that, you gotta go back here. Get more dynamite, and do the process all over again. Also, I'm curious about something, because I noticed something on this map that I don't... Oh, okay. So just to showcase what happens if you... don't, or if you do actually find a hole... Oh, also there is. This one. You blow a hole and you find. Gold bucket. We're rich! I think. How about dynamite? Mike's, I think, 16? And yeah, if you give him the gold nugget, you get score. But also, since it was alluded to earlier, let's get an Easter egg real quick. Yeah. You got a gold nugget. You strike it rich. Wait. Oh, it's a chicken nugget. You try it. Delicious, but nothing happens. Okay, now for realsies, get some dynamite. Okay, there's the chicken nugget. There's another right here. That's one, two, right here. Alright. So now there is Pierce actual progress. You kind of want to always kill these things at an angle. Oh, I can, okay. Oh, also, if I remember correctly, you do not want to hit these, because they will turn into coins that are very... I think I have to anyway. Boss, which technically is on time limit. Not taking a chance. Alright, the donkey. Welcome back, I'm glad that you've come so far. Listen well, I will give you added strength so that you may overcome dangers ahead. You got the super psychic shockwave. Remember, I can powerful magic will guide you in your journey. It's also where it does not say that it will decrease in power. So now we have a slightly longer range and about as strong as our knife. So this is going to be our main weapon for this area. If you use your main weapon, that they turn into coins. I don't think that if you... I don't think there are any enemies that, like, require you to use your main weapon. Want to say it freezes? So thankfully, it's not until you get very low that... you lose it. Pretty sure it's like the first game where you can't, you only get one. Also, this game does not have any instant death chests in the, which is, I guess, kind of nice. Okay, here we go.
Also, you really don't... I believe if you touch it, it's instant death. There's the best tetrad, the eyepiece. We'll see later on why we're collecting Tetris pieces. And now we have this chapter. You appear, where am I? Decided to look around. It is the visitor to Italy, yes? Have a nice time, shall we? Tetrad, I have a no tetrad. How about some nice tetrazzini or tortellini? Hey kid, made a match with the artist's home? What do you say? I got Raphael, Donatello, Michelangelo? You know, sorry, I'm out. I sold the last one to some big weird guy. You're looking familiar. Ever eat at Caesar's Hot Pizza? I'm the pizza man. An old scientist lives in our villa. If he can't help us, no one can. The old scientist in our villa is very inventive. I hear his cellar is full of gadgets, like a big toy box. You look so thin, have a big plate of pasta! Eat pasta, it's delicious. Alright. Oh hey, there's some paint here. Help, I can't move! Get me out of here. Someone's inside the statue! Okay, this level sucks. I don't think it's quite as bad as the sewers, but it still sucks. I'm in a safe state while I have full health. There's not that many enemies here. Why did I think that was a good idea? I think this level is short. Alright, I think here's the main gimmick. You gotta get all the balls. You gotta get all the balls in the hole, except the problem is they gotta time it.
Oh, I did!
Do that. There we go.
Ow!
There's one.
Oh!
Damn it.
Yeah.
That one. Got it.
That's it. This is a very short dungeon.
Oh, you've done it.
We get a chisel.
And hammer.
Now go here.
Get me out of here.
Did you chip away the hammer?
Ow, get me out of here.
Ow, careful, ow. Ow,
careful.
It's a famous artist, Leonardo da Vinci.
Grazie, grazie, thank you for releasing me, friend. I was just putting the finishing touches on my new masterpiece when... A monster blasted me of liquid plaster. What's his name? Zoda?
You shout, Zoda, why? Sherlock was right. Guess you about a curious artifact I saw on an old castle to the east. The Tetrad, you gotta help me get there.
I have just the thing, but first, what do you think of my new masterpiece?
I'm no art critic, but the hairstyle is a little old.
Well, how about this?
That's radical!
Now hurry, an adventure of mine will take you to where I saw the artifact. Take this weapon, too! It's a souvenir of Marco Polo's visit to the Far East.
We got a katana! We got Hanzo Steel!
Get it, cause Leonardo? His katana?
It's a petrifying experience.
And then we get to go on this thing.
Also Marco Polo, who very famously went to Japan. Teddy, I think you're flying. I wouldn't believe what's going on. Tell the story of flying to blah blah blah. Aliens have come to Sea Island. Hypnotized Dr. Jane found out how to time slip. They're after the Tetrads and they're going on a track for you. You don't know what the evil aliens are capable of. I mean, they made the turtles joke later. Or earlier, so I feel like that joke is fitting. Also, you've got a big heart. And now we get back in. Okay. Now we're actually where we're going, which is this castle over here. So this level is interesting. This is basically a giant overworld maze. If I remember correctly, you can actually do this entire dungeon without getting into an encounter. Okay, so... I believe you want to do this. It's
a dungeon.
Okay, that takes us. Oh. Well, here is it's one of these. This takes us here. Hey, B. Okay, this isn't. Nope. Oh, maybe I do actually have to. Okay, I think there is actually a forced encounter. Okay, where was I? Okay, yeah, there is a forced encounter. Okay. So I'm just trying to read where I'm... Okay, yeah, I went the wrong way. Wait. Hey, they didn't mark that on the map.
Oh,
And yeah, as you can imagine, the katana is actually our strongest main weapon. As it should. Oh, they did. I think they just marked it a little... Okay, so... Here? Yeah, there's something they don't... Also, that's another thing about the... encounters is that they were just repeat. Which is kind of annoying. Okay, wait a sec. It's right. One right here, which is just one. That, if I go one, two. Okay. This map is wrong. Oh, I see. This leads us to here. Oh, no. I don't know. Oh, I see. Oh shit. If I remember correctly, you really do not want to get hit by those things. Okay. News is I at least know where I am. What is the... Okay. Okay. They effectively... I've listed them all there. That is all of them. Except for one. I think there's PlayStation in there. I don't think I added that. But now I got the Z. Wait, you hear an evil voice going behind. That's fast, human. And so do I. I've learned now not to send a henchman or errand that requires my own touch. You will not get away so easily where I'm about to send you. Go to a land where a count stalks his victim by the light of the moon. Let's see. Chapter 7. Zoday. Yeah, Zoday, he comments on a lot of tech YouTubers stuff. Alright, before I continue, actually, I will be right back. All right, perfect timing. Okay. So if you guessed that this was Transylvania, you'd be right. Thing about this chapter is that this all is just kind of one big dungeon from what I recall. Also, yes, you have to kill the creature by jump shots, or wait, I think it just does it anyway. Oh, you ha- oh, it's a reverse dark nut. Okay. Remember them pulling an E? Yep. That's what I thought. Thank you. Oh god, I hope I get some health soon. Threshold have. Okay, I'm just gonna do something because this... I'm just gonna deal with this asshole. Is this gonna be check shit on health? Please, for the love of God. Now I'm gonna do that. You know what? Maybe this is what I wanted. Okay, that's what it is. Okay. We're just gonna go that until we get to the boss. I forgot. Well, at least the health is now restored to normal value. Thank you. Wait. Across. Okay. Save state. We are going to turn off invincibility. Okay. I'm gonna save state again. Okay. Offers out of water. I appreciate that the low health sound effect beeped and tuned with the boss dying. Ah, it's the open. It's the old block. Yeah, unfortunately we didn't get to see Dracula. Alright, time for the last proper level. Out of our Dragon Quest. Odds Bodkins, a stranger, methinks that you should go see the king. The shadow of a dragon looms heavy over Camelot. The king seeks a hero to save us. I'm Sir Lancelot, no doubt you have heard of my many wondrous adventures. I have fed the dragon in the northern cave, but my schedule is quite full, so I need quests so little time.
Arthur, our king, is a very strong and important man. You should see him at once. Get out of here, kid. We're training. See, oh, hail, young man. Sir, I am Sir Spineless the Cowardly. I'm glad you showed. I certainly won't go battle dragon. I serve the king. Can I bring you a nice bowl of gruel? Swill. Button. Welcome, welcome to Camelot, Mike. I am Arthur, King of the Britons. Wise old Merlin the Magician told us to expect you, and you are just in time, too. This awful, mean, terrible dragon, you see, kind of been making a mess of things. I'd call my brave and powerful knights, but they all seem to be out on a quest. Would you, brave Mike, smite down this terrible beast? Yes. You're indeed very brave. I hereby christen you Sir Mike. You're now nigh the round table. Good luck on your journey. So yes, we're now a knight. We do not, in fact, get a better sword. See you, Professor Mike. Fight bravely for our kingdom. About this area that's like super dark. Oh. Yeah, I can't see anything. Oh, do I have to kill that thing? Oh, yep.
Ow!
That's full game? Oh, I see now. I thought I did.
Okay. Okay, actually, I just want to double check, because it looked, the ground, it looks like, that looks like a hole. Even though I don't think it is. Oh, it isn't. Okay. Yeah, I cannot see where the... I don't remember this being so... dark. So this is weird boss. Wondering, this boss fight seems like it's completely random. And you'd be correct. I'm just for giggles. Well, it's not... not completely random, but it's like, this feels like it's a fight that's not really... yeah, I guess I'll say no. Also, it's an owl. Remember my other disguises. Hey, it's the monkey and the donkey. Oh, but wait. The guy from the game over is actually Merlin. Oh god, a good friend of faraway planets, his name is Hierathon. He spread the tetrads across time and space so that only a hero could find them. As you spoke, we asked me to watch over a hero in his journey someday, and that hero was you, Sir Mike. Like the last tetrad to put them together, the fate of Hierathon's race will rest on you, and I'll give you the last and most powerful magic. You got the Ultra Psychic Shockwave. Now continue your journey and fight the final tetrad. Which, again, they lack to tell you that in order to use Ultra Psychic Wave, or Ultra Psychic Shockwave, you need full, like... I forgot how much health you need. I guess it's half. It's half. So, yeah, it's as strong as the katana. It goes all the way across the screen. You lose it easily. We'll be right back. Okay, that did less damage than I thought it did. Not see the ground. What is up with the... I do not remember this being quite so dark. There we go, that's... not great looking, but that's... I'm just going to take the damage. I believe that. Oh, the potion's this way. Also, I might as well just finish this on screen because it's like, we're not that far away from the ending. So, remember correctly, the last chapter is rather short. Okay, here it is. Now time to fight the dragon. Which is kind of a pushover. Yeah, it did not, but thankfully, it's a fairly generous time limit. And there we go, final touch rod. And also, full health. Nope, and we can't put it together.
Doc, we need your help. Come back to Sea Island. You turn the last page and say the magic words. Papa oom bow, Papa bow mow. Chapter 9. This is the last chapter. And hey, we're back on Sea Island. And everyone's a pig. Even the chief. But the next character, the strange things happened. I came back from fishing and the villagers turned into boars. Odd sounds have been coming from the tunnel. And now. Get this rehash of the first dungeon from the first game. The way that this remix sounds. Hey, Cedar, have a good rest of your day. And also, yay, the potion's here. Now the question is the other potion here? Or, quote-unquote. So yeah, if you feel particularly daring, no instant death, but it is a much harder one to get.
Thank you.
All right. And time for the sea snake fight again. Yeah, especially since it turns skeletal at the end of one, yeah. Alright. So time for second phase of this level. So at this point, we're in the final stretch. And time for... Time for some goodies. You might be wondering, oh, I wonder why they're giving you so many items. Now, it's time to have our kick beaten too. Okay. So, time for a laugh. And then. Good old fashioned boss rush. Except now you have a long-range weapon, which makes these fights infinitely easier. The original did not. Go. Yeah, it's like... Okay. Time to fight this boss with no potions. Okay, here we go. Okay. God damn it, I hate... Oh. I hate this game. I hate this boss. No, that is me doing it. Bad controlling game. There we go. All right. There's Miko. I have many things to tell you, but now I gotta make sure that the Kirk Collins are okay. Oh, me at the Chia spot. And now we're back here. Hey, she's saving us. Look back to the present. Here you went through time and space. But where do you come from, Miracola? Thanks for hearing us, Mike.
still feel a little strange. Oop. And Miss Carol, remember? You look totally cool. Thank you, Mike. I did enjoy being a pig, though. I think it gets it. Oink, oink. Thanks for saving us, Mike. Hi, Mike. Now you've done it. What a great boy. Hey, Zap to Zotus. Too cool. Show me how to use the Ultra Shockwave sometime. Let's see. Mike, the village is back to normal. You saved us all once again. We'll be forever indebted to you. Now let's put the Tetrads together and see what happens. And here's the chief. The hero returns. Welcome back, Mike. You're a power player indeed. Perhaps I can help you with the Tetris. After all, Tetris is my middle name. Yeah, that's where they change it to Puzzle is my middle name. Also, I like the eyebrow waggle. The chief puts Tetris together. Apologizing for the flashing. And hey, it's Yurikon. Hello, Mike. Thanks so much for saving me. Father, you're alive. Mika, I'm so glad that you arrived here safely. When the trouble began in Argonia, I sent you away in escape pods, and then had my essence transferred to these Tetrads. Now, thanks to Mike, we are all safe. And together we can go back to Argonia and rebuild our society. Goodbye, Mike. I'll be thinking about you. Thanks again, Mike. You will still always hold a place as a hero of Argonia. Oop. That's Star Tropics 2. So yeah, I don't think Star Tropics 2 is bad. It is not as unique as the first game is. It's kind of a bit janky. And yeah, this is a lot more straightforward. It has that this game came out extremely... This is an extremely 1994 game. Also, this ending theme does something I really like when things do. Which it incorporates the little victory music into it, which I think is a nice touch.
Minoru Okawa, who I believe was the president at some point, if not the current president. What a wild adventure. If I hadn't lived it, I wouldn't believe it. There's Star-Crossed 2. The end. Softlock. So yeah, that's Star Tropics 2. It's good to go back to this, because I think I have not played this in a while, so... But, yeah, I guess if we're going to make qualitative measures, I have a better way of doing that. Okay. Where are you, Star Tropics 2? Because I've absolutely played this game before. I'm at B-. Last time was several years ago. Let's see. B-. So what, I think the original's at B? Yeah. I kind of think... If anything, I think Star Tropics might be a little lower rated, but, did I see the Goonies here? I see the okay, if the Mafoth Conspiracy is at B, I think this should be a B as well. Original Super Mario Brothers. R-Type, Section Z, the Arcade. Power Blazer. But I think this is a B. Regardless of the original Star Tropics, I think this is a solid B. It's not terrible. It's rather charming, actually. And actually, speaking of that, I think I'm gonna put the charm in an eh. Some people might think it's a little weird, but I it's a very goofy charm. But yeah. I think that's good for that. Nothing really else to pull out. But yeah, I think that's good for Star Tropics 2. Well, I kind of went a little bit over what I normally do. But before we go, let's go ahead and pull what the next thing is, and you all who are still here can decide what are we going to be doing next. So let's go ahead and pull that card. 3. Alright, chat. Are we... Okay. Are we engaging? Are we tracking down Vile? Which means, are we playing a game of the Carmen Sandiego variety? Or are we engaging in Lola de Puzzle's story time? In which we're playing a old school adventure game? Or story time? Okay, that's 3 downs. Okay, I feel like it far down to Carmine. Okay, that's a pretty solid down. So what are we what kind of story are we engaging with starting next? Yeah, except the problem is this one, I'm pretty certain we don't need to do... and I'm pretty sure we don't need to do voices for this one, because I think those ones voiced. JB Harold, Blue Chicago Blues. This is an interesting game. Also very funny that we picked this right when we were doing Jake Hunter for Thursday. This is a game that, I want to say there was a PC version that was floating out back in the day. This is the 4th entry in the J.B. Hurl Birder Club series. It was released for the version that we've taken a look at is a recently fan-translated Saturn version. Which this is an FMV Birder mystery game. Put out by River Hill Soft, the people who created games like Dr. Hauser and Overblood. So this is going to be a fun time. of seeing late 90s FMV game for the Saturn. That's all the voices are, by the way, despite this being a Japanese game, all the acting is in English. So that's going to be fun. But anyway, that is going to do it for this week. So let's press this funny button. Alright, so thank you all for watching. Personal Twitter /bluesky/co-host is at some form of load up at load of puzzle. Got links in the video description and the chat right now. I got a Discord, you can chat the community, take prompt polls, get notified when I go live. I also have a coffee page where you can help with hosting costs and various other things. And then I got a bunch of other links in the video description and the chat right now if you want to go check them out. So upcoming next week is going to be interesting because on Thursday we're going to be starting Jake Hunter Detective Chronicles for this one. It's like Jake Hunter something for the DS. It's the second one. It's not the first original release, which is going to be weirdly similar to what we're doing, what we just pulled. So that'll be on Thursday. On Friday, because it will be December 1st, we're going to be starting our special holiday season episode or journal in which I just press the potpourri button a lot, and that's going to be that entire set of things. I think I have like 40 entries in the potpourri thing, so I added some videos, so we might have a nice, fun, cozy time with what garbage is in the potpourri stuff. And then next Sunday we'll be starting JB Harold Blue Chicago Blues. So that'll be that. Anyway, I'm just going to send you all on your merry way. So thank you all for watching, and hope to see you again sometime in the future. Bye-bye.